Hi there. This is the third video in the series called Step to Step, Painter 2023, or Painter 2023 Step by Step. I don't remember what I named it, but it was in the previous video. All right, so we're going to continue in this video setting up my workspace and my layout. So what I'm going to do right now is I'm going to go over to Documents here and just open up a new document. And I'm just going to leave it as is, just the standard Painter default document. We'll say OK. Now, I've got this Layers business here, and I've got the Color business here. So I'm going to move the color up over here to this corner. And I'm actually going to close it. I'm going to leave this about here, but I'm going to close it there for the moment and start adding more stuff to this. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to add of it is some more command bars. If you go up to Window and you come down here to Command Bars, you have three different command bars. And this first one, Filed Edit, I can do it with large icons, single column, just like this one is. So that's what I want to do is that. And here is the command bar, which I put right up there. Okay, now the next one to command bars is the canvas. And I'm going to do columns, small icons. It doesn't have columns, large icons. And I'm going to bring that over and stick it right there, just like that. These are some of the tools that are on the main toolbox, but I like it set up this way for whatever reason. This is the way I've always been setting it up. Okay, so then I go to the last command bar, and it's Photo Art, and I do that tall with group labels. And that comes up here, and oops, I can slip it right over here at the very end. And I want to get rid of that. All right, so we now have this set up. Okay, now I want to go back to Windows, and I'm going to come down here to Scripts and click on Scripts. All right, so I'm going to bring this out. I'm going to click here. I'm going to make it a palette drawer. I'm going to rename it to Scripts. And I'm going to want this to come into play right there. That's where most of my stuff will pop up. So all I need to do is put Scripts there, and once I close it like that, it will always come back up there once I save my layout. That's important that I have to save the layout. All right, so what I want to do next is I want to click on my little drop-down menu, and notice there's one that says Import or Export Script Library. You don't have that down here. You can create a new script, or you can import a single script or export a single script. But to get a library, you have to come up here. So I'm going to import a script library, and I'm going to go to my custom painter stuff. And is that where I want to go? Scripts. I'm 2022. I think this is the one I want. Let me open it and see. Paper default, paper text, paper overlay big. Yeah, that's the one I wanted. Okay, so now I've got that in place, and I want to go over to Windows, and I'm going to go to Custom Palette, and I'm going to Organizer. And I'm going to import, and I'm going to import from Painter, custom Painter stuff. I'm going to go to Custom Palettes. And I want to get this one called Toolbar PAL. And I'll open it. And we'll say done for the moment. Okay, so what we just brought in is this. It is a custom palette, but if I take it and rearrange it so that it looks like this, it takes on the look of a toolbar. So I'm going to go and make it a palette drawer, and I'm going to rename it Toolbar. And we'll say OK. And I'm going to drag it right over here. Put it right at the bottom of these things. It just sort of fits in there nicely. So I've got this group of stuff going on. Now, these things here are not going to work at the moment because they were set up in another program. So all I need to do, everything else is like a command that will fit. But I'm going to hold the shift key down, and I'm going to drag that off, drag that one off, drag that one off, and drag that one off. And then I'm going to come up here, and holding the shift key down, I'll drag that one, put it into place. I'll drag that one and put it into place. I'll put this overlay next, which is the way I like to keep it. And then the flow map. Okay. Now I can close that, and so we've got this paper set up, and it's at the default setting, so I'm just going to arbitrarily move some numbers around there, and then I'm going to come over here and click on paper, reset paper default. When I click on it, and I come back up here, you'll see the paper has been reset to the default setting. I love being able to use that. Now, what the other one is, this one, I want to open up my channels, and I'm going to move the channels over to right here. Okay, I'm going to get rid of that second layer, which was part of the opening process. And now that I'm on the canvas, I'm going to come here and click Show Paper. And what that does is it shows what the paper looks like on that canvas setting. So I'm going to undo this a couple of times. And now I'm going to change paper to something different. Let's go to greenery. I don't know what that is, but if I click on that there, now I can see exactly what the paper looks like. And if I wanted to, let's undo a couple of times. If I wanted to change the scale, but I wouldn't know how that looked, and let's say I wanted to make the contrast really strong, it would bring the brightness down. So let's say I decided I wanted it to look like that, but I have no idea what it would look like on the paper, I mean on my canvas, so I can do this Show Paper Text, and now that's what that paper looks like if it were put on the canvas. Now, what I can do next, I'm going to go undo, undo. I want to add a layer that shows that paper texture is on. So that's what this is, paper overlay texture big. And we just click on it, and that gives me a layer that is a gel layer. It's at about 80% opacity, and it's laying right on top of the canvas. And I can lock it, and I could paint in between the two, or I could paint above, you know, whatever I wanted to do. But now I've got this paper showing. All right, so let's, oops, I didn't mean to do that. Let's delete that. And let's see what else. This one is the same thing as the first one. It's a flow map. And it shows the flow map resetting to the default setting. All righty, so that's as far as we've gotten so far today. I'm going to close that. I'm going to come up to Windows, Layout, and I'm going to save the layout. And we'll save it as Skips 2023 and say OK. And it says it's already there. That's good. And we say yes. And we are all done. And at this point, I would close Painter. And then I would reopen Painter. Now, the reason you do that is because it saves all of your workspace and everything else. So you want to frequently close Painter as well. All right. I will see you in the next video. Bye-bye.